want to change the lives of many people in the room beside us. So I'd just like to begin with my story as well. I don't suffer from RP myself. I have a condition called Stevens-Johnson syndrome. It's very rare, it affects 1 in 3 million people. So basically what happened to me 12 years ago, it was actually this week 12 years ago, quite strange. So I was basically prescribed penicillin and I had a really severe reaction to it. It affected my eyes, it affected my lungs. I experienced quite bad blistering and I lost 60% of my skin. I grew new toe fingernails and suffered a lot of hair loss as well. I was in intensive care for about 10 days in a coma. When I finally woke up from my coma, I was unable to see very well. And I had to learn how to walk again as well. I did lose my sight immediately. Probably 6 months after my diagnosis, I lost the sight in one of my eyes. And then another 6 months later, I lost the sight in my right eye. So I've always been one of those independent people. I wanted to resume my education as soon as possible. So about a year and a half after the diagnosis, I joined the RNIB College in Loughborough. And I lived away from home for about 3 years to begin with. This was my first experience of sort of integrating with other visually impaired people, living by myself, learning how to cook. And this is where I became a reflexologist and achieved access to higher education and went on to university. This is where I studied complementary therapies and now practice aromatherapy and reflexology. I then went on to practice at a cancer centre in Leicester, which is what I do now, and offer services there. The thing that's got me through the difficult times is learning how to become independent again. The hardest thing was trying to sort of step outside the door. I did not have the confidence, didn't have the courage. I refused to use a long cane. It just, as somebody was saying earlier, there's a lot of ignorance around using the cane, there's not a lot of awareness. But I knew I had to do it in order to be able to get my guide dog Laura. We've been partnered for about a year and a half now, and she's transformed my independence beyond my imagination. So many amazing things have happened. Little things like being able to get to the shops, being able to use public transport again, which is something I've struggled for a long time, probably. And also the dynamics at home in my family. There was a lot of fear, a lot of anxiety around dogs in general. And I found that she really sort of became part of the family and just changed perceptions. So the fear sort of disappeared from it. And alongside the academic achievement, I was sort of struggling with my health a little bit. I was becoming quite sort of tired and breathless and just really demotivated. And the wake-up call came when I ended up in hospital 3 times in 1 year with a collapsed lung. So I realised then that I needed to seek some kind of help with my health and fitness. So I made a few kind of phone calls and I tried to find the right sort of support. But this is something I really struggle with. I was rejected by a lot of trainers, a lot of gyms, until eventually the perseverance paid off. And I found a trainer who was willing to work with me. And I must admit, I was one of those exercise bear gyms who absolutely hated exercise. I would whinge and moan during every session. But after a while, I began to notice a change. I was feeling fitter, I was feeling healthier. Things began to feel better for myself. 2.5 years on, I'm at a stage now where I actually enjoy fitness. And last December, I was the first blind person to win a National Fitness Award. And in June, I'm hoping to become a fitness instructor. And I'm hoping to change the lives of other visually impaired people too. Because of all the barriers and the challenges that I've actually faced, trying to access health and fitness services, I made it my life's mission to ensure that health and fitness is accessible to people visually impaired. And I have to thank my family, because without them, I don't think I would be standing here, to be fair with you. I would be standing here, I wouldn't have achieved what I have, psychos. There is hope. You can get through anything. And yeah, I'd like to end with a quote from Stevie Wonder, actually, just because someone lacks the use of.